Assalamualaikum and good morning, guys. I'm about to have a very healthy breakfast. Are these functional food and functional beverage? To answer that question and for this note on functional food, we are going to go through the similarities and differences between functional food and medical foods and other categories of food. The American Dietetic Association, or ADA, which is the largest organization of food and nutrition professionals in the United States, classifies all foods as functional at some physiological level. Furthermore, the ADA subdivides food into conventional foods, modified foods, foods for special dietary use, and medical food. Conventional foods are unmodified whole foods such as fruits and vegetables. These foods are in their natural state and have not been modified by enrichment or fortification. Modified foods are foods that have been fortified, enriched, or enhanced. For instance, orange juice can be fortified with calcium to promote bone health. Cereal products can be enriched with folic acid to reduce birth defects. And margarine can be enhanced with plant esters to reduce cholesterol. Special dietary foods are commercially available foods formulated for persons with specific dietary requirements but don't require supervision by a health care provider. For example, infant formula for babies, gluten-free products for individuals with celiac disease, and dairy-free foods for those who are lactose intolerant. Finally, medical foods. These are specially formulated, regulated products for the dietary management of specific diseases. In 1988, the FDA, through the Orphan Drug Amendment, defined medical foods as food which is formulated to be consumed or administered internally under the supervision of a physician and is intended for the specific dietary management of a disease or condition for which distinctive nutritional requirements based on recognized scientific principles are established by medical evaluations. There are 5 criteria that clarify the characteristics of medical food. We are going to detail this in class, but these 5 criteria include requirement for feeding of patients and something to do also with medical supervisions. It is important to note that medical foods cannot prevent or cure illness, but are used to manage the cause of disease. Examples of medical foods include a product such as Banatrol Plus, consisting of banana flakes and prebiotics for the treatment of diarrhea, Deplin or L-methylfolate for dietary management of suboptimal folic acid levels in depressed patients, and Fosteum, which is a blend of the soybean isoflavone with chalazone, which is a form of zinc, and vitamin D3, which is a medical food for osteopenia and osteoporosis. Now, how about dietary and nutritional supplements? These are derived from food products and are intended to provide extra health benefits in addition to the basic nutritional value found in food. They include vitamins, minerals, herbs, and other botanicals, amino acids, enzymes, etc. They can be extracts or concentrates, as well as liquid form, capsule form, tablet form, soft gel form, gel cap, or even powder form. Nutraceuticals is a combination of the words nutrition and pharmaceutical, actually coined in 1989 by Dr. Stephen DeFelice, a founder and chairman of the Foundation for Innovations in Medicines. He defined nutraceutical as a food or part of a food that provides medical or health benefits, including prevention and treatment of a disease. Therefore, the term nutraceutical has no regulatory definition, just like functional food, and is commonly used interchangeably with dietary or nutritional supplement. In the United States and many other countries in the world, the term functional food is a marketing expression with no legal meaning or regulation by the FDA. So we use FFC definition that is based on science, even though the legal definition is not really there. Functional food can carry health claim. For instance, this particular orange juice has been fortified with plant esters that reduce cholesterol and therefore can reduce the risk of heart disease. Alternatively, the juice can carry content claim, as described in this orange juice containing added calcium and vitamin D. So, manufacturers may offer functional food with health claim or with content claim. The legal requirements for putting in the health claim on your products are specified in Food Act and regulations. It is logical that requirements for health claim should be more stringent than those of content claim. All of these products fall under the umbrella of functional food. They are all health food. They are intended to promote health. Medical foods differ from functional food in that they are specially formulated and regulated for the dietary management of a specific disease. And while a prescription is not required, they are consumed under medical supervision. Functional foods, including dietary supplements, are generally used by healthy individuals and do not require the guidance of medical practitioners. The focus of our course is on the design and development of functional food. We will not do any medical food or nutraceutical or supplements. You will not find the term functional food or nutraceutical on any labels of food in the supermarkets. However, products that is considered as functional or as nutraceuticals are there. These are real, scientifically validated products that can really contribute to health. Okay guys, I guess I have to go, but remember the learning outcome is all about understanding the differentiation and what this course is all about. Take care and happy learning.